Hey, what's going on? It's Tsai here. So in this video, I want to talk about how you can send up automate follow-up messages and also how you can integrate the entire platform using automation. Right. So inside automation, there are actually two ways for you to manage your follow-up email. The first one is workflow, and the second one is campaign. So the campaign was the old feature, and the workflow is the new one. And the good part of the workflow is that it integrates everything you need in your campaign and trigger. So if you are using workflow, basically you don't need campaigns and triggers, but I will cover them in this training as well. But because some people, they may prefer the old way. But right now, let me show you the easiest way to manage your follow-up system and also manage your pipeline. So that is workflow. So you can go to automation and go to workflows, and you can create workflow. Right. Then the next thing you want to do is you can either import the workflow from an existing campaign. For example, if someone give you a campaign, you can turn that into a workflow, or you can start from scratch, or you can use their recipes so that you don't have to do everything from scratch. So right now we choose start from scratch. Then before you start doing anything, you want to give it a name, right? Then you want to add the trigger of the workflow. So the trigger is how and when people enter this automation, enter this workflow. Maybe because they sign up from the form, right? Then you want to choose when someone sign up a form. And also you want to add filters, right? For example, you want to choose which form they sign up. Maybe they sign up from a very specific form, right? Then you can save trigger. So when someone go to the website and when they see the form, when they submit the info, they will enter the workflow. Then the first thing you want to do is you want to update or create opportunity. So if you already have a pipeline, you just choose the pipeline, right? So for example, you can say, hey, this is a buyer lead from website, right? Then you can choose the stage, right? Then you can give the opportunity a name. Maybe you can say, oh, this is a website lead. Then you can give it, or you can even add contact information here, right? And you can give the a resource, right? Maybe website or funnel. And you can give it a net value, right? Then you can save action. So the first thing you do is you create or update opportunity. Then you want to send them follow-up emails, right? So you can say, hey, thanks for signing up, right? So you can send them an email. Hey, thanks for signing up. Then you can leave messages here. So this is your follow-up email. You can even send a test email to your inbox so you know how it looked like in your inbox, right? Then you can save action. And maybe some people, they don't really want to use email, or maybe they don't open email much. So you can also send SMS at the same time. You can say, hey, thanks for signing up, things like that. So you can send an SMS at the same time. Then after that, you can wait for a few days, right? So you can wait for maybe one day, right? And then you can also send in other messages, right? So you can send in another email. So you can say, hey, I didn't get your message. How's things going? Things like that, right? So as you can see, you can keep on building this automation. So the system will send out those email automatically to your leads, right? And you can even do an if and else, right? So you can say, oh, if someone do something, then they go to another branch, right? So for example, or maybe you can say, oh, if they are in the city, right? Maybe they are in New York, then they go to another branch. So you will send different message based on their condition. So after everything is set, you can give the workflow a name, maybe sign up, then you can turn this on. So be sure to turn the workflow on, and you can test it as well, right? So you can send the workflow to someone, then you go back to the workflow. So right now we are creating another one because I want to show you how you can use one workflow to control another. So we create a new workflow. Right now we are creating a new workflow, but the trigger is different. So this is for someone who replied to our previous workflow, right? So you want to choose customer replied. Then you want to add trigger. For example, the trigger can be late reply to the workflow. Then you choose the previous workflow. So the previous workflow were triggered when someone opt in, when someone submit their information on your form. And this workflow were triggered when they reply any message in that workflow. So you save trigger. Now, then the next thing you want to do is you want to update the opportunity. So you want to move then to the next stage of the pipeline, right? So you can choose the pipeline. Then you can say, oh, right now they're going to reply stage, right? Then the next thing you can do is you can remove them from the previous workflow, right? So maybe the previous workflow is to send email to ask them to reply, right? So right now they replied, you want to send them other messages, right? So right now you choose the previous workflow, so you remove them, then you can send them new emails or new SMS. Right, so you can just say anything here. Right, and you can also wait a few days. Then you can keep on sending messages. So right now, the workflow we're working on get them to call you or to book an appointment with you. Right, then be sure to turn it to publish. So this is for replied. Right now, let's create another workflow, and this is for someone who book an appointment with you, right? So we create workflow, so we can still start from scratch. Then you can add new trigger. So you can say, oh, if someone book an appointment, when you can add filter, maybe you can say, oh, if they are in a calendar, right? Then you can save trigger. So if the customer book an appointment, then you start a trigger. So right now you want to remove them from another workflow. Maybe replied. Then you want to update the opportunities, right? So you can say, okay, right now we are moving them to the next stage. So right now you want to send a new series of emails, right, to remind them to show up on the call, right? So this is in. So also you can say I'll publish. So another thing you can do is you can send them a reminder email, and HighLevel make it super easy to create a reminder. So you can say, hey, this is Nick Tsai. Then you can give it a name. You can say, oh, this is a reminder. So the feature here is what I call custom values, right? So you can insert the custom value. So you can say, hey, hi, something, something, like thanks for book an appointment with me at, then you can insert the date, right? At, right, then you can insert the location. So if it's an online meeting, then you can insert the link here, right? So you can say the location. Then you can say, oh, if you want to cancel or reschedule a meeting, you can visit here. Then you send in another link, custom value, appointment cancellation link, right? Then you leave your name here. And also you can copy the message, then you can send an SMS. So some people, they prefer using SMS, so you can use that as well. So that's how you can send a reminder. So right now you may be wondering, hey, what if I want to send them an email before 24 hours of the meeting. Can I still do that? And yes, you can do that. So that's another really powerful a part of this software. So you can go to wait. So right now we don't set as time delayed. We set as event and appointment time. So you can say before 1 day, then you can save next save action. Then you can send them another email reminder or SMS reminder here. Say, hey, it's only 24 hours until our meeting. So you can say something to make them feel excited about the meeting. So that's another thing, like you can set a wait time and you can wait until maybe 24 hours before the meeting. Then they will send them the email before the meeting to remind them to show up on the meeting. So that's another pretty powerful feature inside the platform. Then you go back. Right, so right now let me create another one. So this one is for someone who scheduled an appointment, but they didn't show up. So the trigger is different, right? So the trigger will be, you can choose appointment state at filter. So the state is no show, right? So after that, you will send them another message or email. You can say, is there any issue? Right, so you want to show you care about them. You can say, hey, Mr. something something, right? So you can say, oh, user full name, thanks for schedule a meeting with me. I noticed that you didn't show up. So you insert a date. So you can say, okay, is there anything I can help? Then you can ask them if you want to schedule another meeting, you can do it here. So you can send them a link to schedule another meeting, then you can leave your name here. Right, so you can actually create a workflow in any conditions, like, oh, if they reply to email, oh, if they show up, oh, if they don't show up. Oh, so you can do so many things inside on HighLevel, and that's the reason why I highly recommend this platform. So if you want to try it for free, you can go to gethlfreetrial.com. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed that. I will see you soon in the next one.